come to play, they have one thing on their minds: making your life as fucking miserable as humanly possible. Raiders can't be bought. This'll just shoot you in. So run, hide, or fight if you've got the balls and the guns. For God's sake, don't go waving the white flag. They'll just scramble. Now, some music.
much like some rain.
Listen to this. Who says you can't go home again, huh? The kid from Vault 101 did, but it looks like the prodigal son's return didn't last all that long. He was
little sister, I've stashed away a considerable amount of fuel behind the small building west of the air traffic control tower as you requested. The container's tucked away under some barrels and tires. And no, I couldn't safely confiscate an incinerator for you. That's your job. I took too big a risk hiding that fuel for you in the first place. If you do come across an incinerator, please be careful. Anyway, they're shipping me out to some relay station far west of here in the wasteland. I'm afraid I won't be seeing you for a while. Take care, and good luck in all your endeavors. Your big brother.
Ungodly amount of radiation, and haven't had the good fortune to die. Sure, they may look like hideous zombies from an old monster flick, but their hearts, their souls, their tears are all very much human. So please, if you meet one of the Capital Wasteland's mini ghouls, leave your prejudice at the door, and your pistol in its holster. Ah yes, one important caveat, kiddies. Those feral ghouls that prefer the dark, dank underground? They are basically mindless zombies, so kill as many as you damn well please. And now, some music.
I'm as corny as Kansas in August. I'm as normal as blueberry pie.
something. Yes, by all means, let's. Something to say? Yes, by all means, let's.
I've stashed away a considerable amount of fuel behind the small building west of the air traffic control tower as you requested. The container is tucked away under some barrels and tires. And no, I couldn't safely confiscate an incinerator for you. That's your job. I took too big a risk hiding that fuel for you in the first place. If you do come across an incinerator, please be careful. Anyway, they're shipping me out to some relay station far west of here in the wasteland. I'm afraid I won't be seeing you for a while. Take care, and good luck in all your endeavors. Your big brother.
And I'm your fellow Goombay. Soon we'll reach that red letter day. When I will pop the question, and you say okay. Say, then we'll be married in the month of May.
Wonderful life. think of the mighty one. Yes, when there's work to do, you better think for the mighty one. Yes, he'll be on the job until the job is done.
Men and ladies, boys and girls, prepare to be astounded, bedazzled, and otherwise stupefied. I'm Three Dog, your master of ceremonies. Let me ask you something, children. You hungry for some 200-year-old Salisbury steak? You hungry for some news? I'm guessing news. Here you go. Don't lose hope, children. Don't ever lose hope. The kid from Vault 101, the Wasteland's one true messiah, still walks among us. This, faithful listeners, is the story of a little boy. A little boy named Brian Wilkes. You see, Brian's from Greatage, a small settlement that was recently overrun with overzealous giant ants. Brian, sadly, was the sole survivor. That's where the kid from Vault 101 comes in, and where our story, thankfully, gets better. You see, not only did Mr. Vault 101 stop the ant problem, he also found little Brian Wilkes a new home. So if you see Brian and his new parents, wish them all good luck. Oh, and 101, nice work. Thanks for listening, children. This is Three Dog, ow! And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio. We're Radio Free Wasteland, and we're here for you. And now, some music.
Yes, by all means, let's...